mic turn off. So, thank you.
Thank you. morning. I feel like we have already had church, so you guys can go home. I'm just joking. God has some good stuff coming up, and I'm just real excited about this fruit. Man, I've already had some tears going, so that's some tears to me, sir. But anyway, it's good, and God is good, and I'm excited to see what our morning will look like. But we do have concerns, and if you will, maybe you can see this for us this morning. God, we come with you with excited hearts, joyful, because we know we're in the Lord's house and we know that you're going to do a good work in all of us here. Lord, I feel your spirit present. Man, it feels good. Thank you for allowing us to come on this campus to worship you, to honor you, to give you glory for all the awesome stuff that you have done in our lives. The things that you're doing here at Duncan and the opportunities of ministry beyond these walls, Lord, we thank you for that. God, we just ask for guidance as we go and continue to work here in the Christian and beyond. There's hearts here that are full of joy, Lord, and there's hearts here that are heavy. The names that were lifted this morning, you know their situations. And we just ask that you wrap your arms around those families, that you bring people to intercede, to be the love, to show that love of Christ in this situation, to give them strength, to give them hope, to remind them that you're an awesome God that's there for us no matter what. You never leave us nor forsake us. And that we can bring some joy into our life. God, thank you. Be with us as we continue to do worship this morning. In your name. I'm even more proud of his parents that had those kids here this morning. That was so exciting. So thank you, parents, so much. If you haven't noticed, we are talking about stories this morning, and I wanted to share a little bit about what stories meant for me when I was little and now even growing up. When I was younger, there was a specific storybook that I really, really enjoyed, and I actually brought a copy of it this morning with me, and it was Goodnight Game. And we had many copies of these growing up because we would tear the pages and rip them up and just do all different types of things with it. But it was one of our favorite stories. We knew when mom or dad or even our grandparents or whoever it was tucking us in that night, we knew that this was going to be the story that was being read to us, or at least one of them. And it was one of our favorites. And so we were excited to move through the pages, and then we got a little bit older and we started reading to each other. And then we got older, and my mom had an empty nester. And so when we were in college, she decided to send this copy with us. And this copy actually has her voice in it. So as we're reading it, as we're trying to pick, you can hear my mom's voice. And so it's special, right? These books are special to us, and I'm sure you guys have one that's special to you. There's just something about stories, right? Especially the really good ones. And not to be, you know, mean to y'all, but kids love stories too, but we adults love stories as well. Stories entertain, they teach us, they inspire us, and provoke us, right? Stories are almost like a container He mapped out our journey with him from the beginning to the end. Are we following his journey? Is his story unfolding as he planned for you and me? Perhaps we're experiencing unexpected thoughts and twists. Maybe you're here today and you're in a dramatic chapter. Maybe you're here today and you've had surprise turn events in your story. You see, we question God's care and concern for us when our stories seem to veer off course. We all have those chapters in life, you know, the ones that we want to keep quiet. The ones that we just want to keep to ourselves. And then we have the chapters that, well, I'm just going to talk to God, just between me and God, and that's it. And I want to tell you today, these chapters do not define you guys. These chapters do not define God's story for you. They do not define who you are, who he created you to be. You see, God's story for us is one of love and redemption. Love and redemption. We keep our faith strong, trusting in the author of our life stories. And when I thought about this day, this moment, I went to Pastor Ross because this was put on my heart, like, back in the summer to do this. So I know there's someone here that needed this, and I needed it. And God's to remind me of the story of Joseph. If you have God's story for Joseph, his love never changes. And Joseph's love for God never wavers, right? It made me think, how many times in the chain of events of Joseph's story would he have been tempted to give up? How many times are we tempted to give up? How many times might he have felt forgotten or abandoned by the Lord? You may be here today, or you may be watching, and you just feel completely abandoned by the Lord because your chapter is a mess. And you haven't seen the Lord in your life in a while. You haven't felt him in a while. You feel abandoned. Yet God's story, listen to this, God's story has a beautiful ending. Joseph places his utmost faith in God for his deliverance. His Lord works all the evil against him for his own good and the good of God's people. Are we tempted to give up on God's story of Christ because the plot, the twist, and turns seem more than we can even bear? And I know some of you here are dealing with that. I have dealt with that. It is too much, Lord. What are you doing to me? This chapter, I do not want to go back. I've already been in chapter 1, why do I want to go back? God's story for us, like Joseph, is one of love and redemption. We are never alone, y'all. He is with us, no matter what. If we keep our faith in our mighty Lord, he will keep our story on track and lead us to a glorious ending, one you could have never imagined, right? If you're a book person, if you love stories, and you're at the very end, and you're like, oh my gosh, and then you get, right? You're like, what? Why did I spend all this time on this book? I'm telling you right now, God's story isn't like that. You're going to be celebrating. You are going to be hollering. You're going to be dancing like David would. It's a glorious ending. He promises to work whatever evil comes against us life. So let me just mimic what they're doing. God has a specific role for you. I can't carry out. You only can carry out. You can only carry it out. It's a specific thing in mind. And here's what I'm saying. If I'm trying to be someone else in the storyline, my story will not have the same ending. Meaning that God intended to me to have. So, are you playing a character in your story? Wondering why am I stuck in the same scene? Or maybe you're here today and you are saying, you know what? I don't have a story that has God in it. Like, I don't even know if I should be trusting this Christ that you're talking about today. Maybe you're here and you're saying, I'm kind of seeking, I'm kind of testing, I'm searching. Maybe you're here and you've been searching for so many things and nothing seems to be working. Nothing seems to be fulfilling you the way it seems. I'm still encouraging you to share that story. Because here's what the good news is, church. The good news is He loves you. There is a God that loves you. There is a God that loves you. Culture will say differently, but He loves you. Trust me, your story will turn upside down for the good. And it will be beautiful. You might go through some dramatic chapters. You might go through twists and turns. Your plot might not be happy all the time. But there's a God that will give you strength. There's a God that loves you enough to go through it with you. So wherever you are in your story, the beginning, the middle, or the end, I want you to know this. Listen really carefully. I'll have a test there. No matter what you bring, no matter what baggage you have, He's in love with you. No matter your past or what you've done, He's in love with you. No matter your unbelief, He's in love with you. From now to eternity, He still be in love with you. And that is the story of God. And you have every opportunity to do it. There's so many places you can do it in your workplace, in the golf course, the sports that you're in, the school that you're in, the hallways that you're in, the grocery lines. There's a story to tell, and it's about love and redemption. As we end this morning, jump right in. I mean, they're so eager to jump into their story, Lord. God, thank you again for this morning and blessing us and the children. In His name, we pray. Thank you.